Hello everyone and welcome to Sousa Plays. It's time again to have a new race introduced to the game. This time it's the Nurgle. They've been released today and I have never played Nurgle and I haven't heard much about their team. The only thing I know is that they're a bashy team. They're supposed to be sort of like Chaos, but maybe a little bit more optimized. That there are some people that have the claw palm combo, and they also are undead type, so they have regeneration instead of apothecary. That's how I understand it. They're undeads with claw, mighty blow, and pylon access. That is mutation access, probably, is the important part there. So let's have a look, shall we? I will dig and create a team, and there they are, Nurgle. As you can see, they look pretty mutated, well, at least on that picture. These guys don't look very mutated, but the beast of Nurgle, which is their big guy, is basically a big blob type monster. And then they have these linemen, which looks like zombies with a sort of a infected skin, are their linemen. I believe they actually have a negative trait, but we will see that quite soon. So yeah, basically Chaos that's been infected with Nurgle's rot. And let's see, strength. They can frustrate tactics based on agility. They can also frustrate tactics based on strength. All right, that seems pretty good. And a constant supply of rotters. Face are fragile for a team given to combat. Expensive rerolls and poor ball handling capabilities. Well, that's what you're gonna have to give up if you are going to play Bashy, which this is a Bash team. We are gonna create that, but I just remembered something. If you look in the shop, we should be able to see if there are any new star players over here. So let's look at star players. And from the last page we have Lord Borak the Despoiler, who used to be just a Chaos Warrior, but now he's gotten his own helmet, he's gotten a bit of a beefier look, he sort of looks like Mighty Zug in his build, with a pretty cool looking helmet, I'd say. Although I don't really know what good the horns would do if you put them both together like that and put a skull on top. You can't really use them for anything. But it looks good. Anyone else? No, Luthor we had before. Alright, so no new star player for Nurgle. They do get access. Hey, he's actually the guy who's on the star player picture up there. No. Well, that's good. Alright, let's get to creating a team here. Nurgle, of course. So, these are the warriors, apparently. They look like Chaos Warriors, but I don't exactly know if they're just like Chaos Warriors in stats and such. You'll see. They have a horn in the helmet and spikes on the side there. I'm just gonna name them Hello Nurgle. Let's see if that's taken. Don't need a team portal. Let's look at the logos. We have some skulls there, helmet with the arrows. Those arrows are on one of the Chaos emblems. This is like a poison football, tentacle football, some other various models. Most of them has to do with infestation and disease, and apparently tentacles. Well, doesn't matter which one we do pick. Green would probably suit them pretty well. That looks pretty fearsome. Yellow and blue. That was white and blue. Smudged. Looks pretty good. I don't know about this one. Purple and green is usually one of my favorites. Not sure if the fits Nurgle very well. Copper looks okay. I like that the armor is sort of dented and scratched here and there. They're not supposed to look pretty. Red armor, always a favorite. That green is probably not the one you want. Well, I don't know what you want. Not the one I'd choose. I'd choose the other green, that looks pretty good. Cabal vision, white and blue. Bronze checker, it looks kind of strange. Sort of melds in with the body color. Mordheim. Looks pretty scary. They have the emblem on their backs, apparently. This one is a little bit too bright for them. Of course, the black armor, fan favorite. And I don't know about this. This is okay. I think I would go with this one, green and yellow. Alright, well, no new stadiums, so let's just say. Try them out, because we are going to try them out. This will be my first time playing Nurgle. Create. And no, we do not want our assistant coach doing this, because this is what we need. So apparently, they're linemen who look sort of like zombies but have a little bit different animation are called Rotters. Their beastmen are called Pestigors. Bestigor. And then we have Nurgle Warriors. Apparently, yes, that's what they're called. And the Beast of Nurgle. Ugliak the Kitten is the suggested name. Nurgle's Rot is what they have. So let's have a look at this thing. Wow. That is different from anything else in the game. It really made an unique model here. I mean, you can't complain about it not looking scary enough. Can't wait to see how this thing's gonna move and fall over and attack. Probably just claws people. Yeah, that looks scary. Is there any other? No, there's the only one look. You can probably understand that. It probably took a lot of modeling to get this done, considering how long it usually takes them to get the modeling done for other things. It has a disturbing presence, which means you have to roll a 2+ to be able to tackle it, even if you're in position. Foul appearance. That's the one that. Does that. Disturbing pressing is what Yetis have. It ruins passing plays. Or specifically, pass, intercept, and catch rolls gets a -1 if they're within 3 squares of him, even if he's knocked out on the ground. Mighty Blow. Big guy start with Mighty Blow. No block, as you can see. But he does. No, he does not have general access. He has strength access only. So you need to roll a double to get block. You can also get claw if you roll double. So you want to roll double twice. If you roll double once, you probably pick claw, because you want claw mighty blow, right? Unless you can get it on other people, and then maybe you go for block. Four movement, 5 strength. He has really stupid as his negative trait, which is the same as a troll. So you need people around him. I thought he had bonehead, but he has really stupid. Okay, that's a little bit weaker. And the tentacles, he starts with them. So that's what's good, is you get 3 tentacles here, and 3 disturbing presence, and 3 foul appearance. So you definitely want this guy marking your agile enemies, because the tentacles will hold them in place with 5 strength. And let's look at Nurgle's Wrath. This is new to the game, this hasn't been in before. When this player kills an opponent during a block, blitz, or foul action, even fouls, the infected opponent becomes a Nurgle Rotter. The opponent's strength cannot exceed 4, he cannot have the decay, regeneration, or stealthy skills, so you can't kill zombies and make them into Rotters. You can't kill other Rotters and make them into Rotters. So basically it's like the undead's necromancer, only that it's instead player specific. So it has to look at who does the killing, and if it's someone with Nurgle's Rot, then you get a new one. The bad thing is, if someone dies from being pushed into the crowd or from failing a dodge, you don't get a Rotter. But the good thing is you can get more than one per game, which is not true with Necromancer. So that's good, you can get new players, same way Undead get new zombies. Alright, let's buy one of these kittens. And what was the cost? 1400. But you probably want... Well, not 1400, 140,000. You probably want him though. His tentacles alone will make him a useful player, I'd say. Although you don't want to risk the really stupid thing, because then he loses his tackle zones. And then they do nothing. So, you're allowed 4 warriors and 4 pestigores, and the rest has to be rotters. The warriors cost 11, the pestigores cost 8. They're basically beastmen with regen and Nurgle's Rot. The Nurgle warriors are agility 2 chaos warriors with disturbing presence, foul appearance, Nurgle's Rot and regeneration. That's a lot of extra skills they get. So these warriors are going to be pretty good if they get a couple of levels. And let's see, they do have the same benefit as chaos. They get general strength and mutation skills. You can easily make claw pile on mighty blow by picking skills from strength and mutation, and of course you want block probably as well, so you don't have to waste your rerolls. Apparently rerolls are expensive. Let's have a look at them. They have at least 4 heads. They have 5 heads. There's one. There's the first one, the one we saw on the team creation page. We have this, which looks like the Chaos Helmet, but only filled out with some sort of yellowish goo. This also looks like one of the Chaos Helmets. And this also looks like one of the Chaos Helmets. This one, although, is unique. They don't look exactly like the Chaos Helmets. It looks like they've taken the Chaos Helmets and done some modifications. Maybe just some reskinning, I don't know. Might call that lazy, but I think it looks okay, and that's pretty good. This one is actually, maybe this one's based off one of the Chaos Helmets as well. I don't know. But starting with all this, of course, having regeneration, the drawback is that you don't get an apothecary, I'm pretty sure. So you can't choose. If your regeneration fails, then that's that. But then again, the apothecary is sort of a 50% chance. It's a little bit than a 50% chance to save them from injury, if that's what you want to do. And this one can, well, it can't save them from a badly hurt as easily as an apothecary, so maybe that's the drawback. And it does nothing for KOs. Although it's very rare that you would use your apothecary to cure a KO anyway. Nurgle's Rot, of course. Foul appearance, so they're going to be tough to deal with. Well, not really tough, but this one will probably kick in at the most inopportune time when you're playing against these guys. So you can't ever trust that you will be able to push them away or knock them down. You always have to roll the 1 in 6. And are risking to fail it. Let's buy one of these. Well, it looks like he's throwing up and it's not moving. It's a little bit disconcerting. We want one of each, but I do think we want the warriors here. Although you probably can't get everybody, huh? The rotors are very cheap. They only cost 40k. Although they do have a decay, which we'll get to in a second. So if I were to get, let's count, 1400, these would cost 400, let's say 1400, I mean 140. This is 440 for 4 of them, meaning we're up to 580. 4 of these would be another 36, which would mean we only have 10k left. And that's enough, not enough to buy 3 rotters. We have to skimp on something here. I do think we want at least 2 warriors and at least 2 pestigores. Let's have a look at these guys. Pestigore. Almost pestigore. It looks like a beastman with the eyes covered and a little bit of a... what would you call that? Not a beer belly, more of a... of a rot belly? I don't know. Okay, there's different faces. I mean, yes, it's basically the Chaos Horse. Well, that one I'm not sure is actually one of the Beastmen horns. Just that one I recognize. That one maybe as well. There's only 5 of them. Maybe they're more unique than that. They all have the belly though. So let's get at least 2 of those. And let's have a look at the Rotters. Cardell the Decayed. Do these have zombie faces? Quite. They actually look pretty unique. Although this, the way they hold the helmet sort of reminds me of how zombies look. So this face is the first. We have this face. He looks like a happy fellow. We have this guy. This guy with his long hair, this guy which is sort of a mohawk, and this fellow. He looks like one of the Bretonian linemen. Oh, and there's a 7th as well. 7 different ones. Pretty good. And now, decay actually is a negative skill, a negative trait. When he suffers a casualty result on the injury table, roll twice on the casualty table and apply both results. He will only ever miss one future match as a result of his injuries, even if he suffers 2 results with this effect. Successful regeneration roll both results. So if he should get injured, you have to roll twice for an injury. Meaning he can take stat debilitating injuries twice as often. Or deaths, even, twice as often. He can actually die twice at the same time. But I think that means he only dies once. And then you roll regen and you have a chance to negate it anyway. But there's a bigger chance that they get bad injuries, you could say. 5 movement, 3 strength, 3 agility, armor 8. They're like zombies otherwise, only that they don't have regen. But if they had decay, it says a successful regeneration roll will heal both results. They don't have regeneration though. Oh, I thought they had regeneration actually. But in that case, they will probably die a lot. But all linemen are made to be expendable. And mutation access on linemen is something you don't get on every team. What could you pick for mutation that would be good for a lineman? I don't know. I mean, claw is always good, but if you're counting on them to get knocked out, I'm not sure. Oh, let's buy one of these. We need at least 3, we know. Actually, we only need 2, right? 1, 4, 4, 2. That would be 11. So we could actually afford that. 20k to go and no rerolls at all. Yeah, they don't get an apothecary. Well, let's do this then. Let's get 3 warriors. And I'm gonna check something here. Yeah, they get general strength mutation just like Chaos. 3 warriors, 3 pestigores. 4 rotters then? And enough for only 1 reroll. That's not very good. So let's fire one of our pestigores. We have to go back on that and buy 3 rotters instead. Then we can at least get 2 rerolls. I'm not sure what you're supposed to start with here. I do want to try the Beast of Nurgle. Maybe a better start would be to not choose the Beast of Nurgle, get four warriors, four Pestigors, get them their levels started, get some block and mighty blow on these guys, and then get the Beast of Nurgle a little bit further in. The Beast of Nurgle being pretty good right out of the box, and that would allow you to do that, to build your team a little bit in the start. So I want two rerolls. There's no necromancer showing. You get people with Nurgle's Wrath instead. Let's not spend anything on fan factor. Alright, confirm purchases. Done. So there we are. There's our team. Everybody has Nurgle's Wrath. So anyone who kills somebody would cause us to get a new rotter. Jonas the Belated Water Boy. Interesting name. Fresh's Rotleg. Rayan Attractus. Cardal the Decayed. Matthias the Gangrenous. These names seem to be the same as Chaos. Corruptor. Demetrian. I don't know about those. I think they're unique. These seems to be not the same as zombies. Although they share some of the suffixes here, like the Decayed. The Kitten I haven't seen before. That's pretty good. Alright. Well, that's the team. There's nothing else new here. So, I'm going to play a game against the AI to try out the animations. I'd rather play the AI then, because I can control the game a little bit better, and I know my opponent won't quit or stall or prevent me from trying to score with the Beast of Nurgle or something like that. So, let's look at that and see what animations we can find. I'll go back here. Here's our team. Hello, Nurgle. Join a league, and I don't want to play multiplayer, I want to play solo. So let's make a cup with two teams. It means it's us and one more team. Apparently they're necros. Do I want to play necros? Well, sure. Why not? Right. Let's get to the game. Okay, before that, let's see what they can get here. You can get a mercenary of each of their players. They get Brickforth and Grotty, same as Chaos. Lewd Greep, same as Chaos. Grashnus Blackhoof, same as Chaos. Morgenthorg and Lord Borak the Despoiler. So they get the exact same star players as Chaos. Now we're not gonna get anything. We could get a babe. Maybe I should get a babe. I mean, I'm not spending the money on anything else. This is just a show off the team sort of thing. And if we get super unlucky and our Beast of Nurgle is knocked out on turn one or something, this will at least give us a chance to get it back. Alright. I think this will be, from what I've heard, this is a popular team. They're sort of like Chaos, but with regeneration is mainly what you're going for. And the fact that you have a little bit of extra disturbing presence and a little bit of extra, what else did you get? There's one more skill. Yeah, now it goes rot, so you get three players. Even better in attrition game. Alright, they're gonna start on the attack. Let's have a look at our opponents. This is more of a, yeah, two wolves, two whites, two flesh golems. No ghoul. That's good, because we have no tackle. Do we want to put our kitten on the line here? I'm not sure how the AI plays Necro. I don't think I've ever seen an AI play Necro. But they have four strength. I don't think we would want to waste these guys on the line. I think they're best off back here. I also don't think you should start with your big guy on the line. As the AI, you might get away with it, of course. You can get away with most things against the AI. But, you probably want to set up something like this. Keeping your more important players back here. I figure these guys, when you play Chaos, these guys are your expendable ones. But here they're probably more of a blitzer type, who you don't want to put in too much contact. You start with no block though, so the rerolls are gonna be pretty important early on. Hopefully I can deal with that. Alright, and before we start, let me turn on the animations for everything. At least for a little while, so we can see the movement and stuff. Settings. And you have graphics, usually. Can't you change that? Maybe not during the kick. Oh no, there it was. I'm blind, apparently. Right up top. All cutscenes, okay. I was looking for animations, not for cutscenes. Okay, here's the kick. Same kick animation as Beastman. I expect that most of the animations are going to be similar to Chaos. Although I've heard that the drop kick that the Chaos do is not in with these. I'm gonna put the beast there because I expect the AI to follow up their blocks here, and then we can get a block in with Kitten here. I don't wanna completely underestimate the AI. Still have to worry about 8 movement wolves. But as you can see, he's using them to tag Rotters. So this guy has to pick up the ball now. I have a feeling he'll blitz with him though. No, it looks like he's actually trying to pick up with him. Good, so he's gonna blitz here. That's the pickup. Why am I not seeing any running animations, by the way? They're not. Let's see here then. Rotter with 8 armor value, we should see. Right. And that's not an armor break. Okay, so the animations are on. Right, here comes a flesh golem on a Rotter. He did follow up, as expected. Same here. You don't get an animation for pushes, apparently. And then you make this 2-die into a 2-die, and you take a zombie hit. Of course the AI doesn't choose both down if it doesn't have to. And he's gonna mark us out here, not bad. Okay. Well, let's see what we can do. We can hit with a Rotter. We can hit with the Beast of Nurgle, we can hit with Pestigore, but we don't have any Chaos Warrior, or sorry, Nurgle Warrior in range. So what I'll do is I'll blitz this zombie, which seems like probably a bad move if you want to play for keeps, but I'm going to do it anyway. This Pestigore might get surfed if the computer, if the AI suddenly has a surge of intelligence. Well, we're not gonna take your bot down, so we're gonna have to wait until to see the armor break animation of a Nurgle warrior. I should stand up here. Okay, you put this Pestigore here and this Nurgle warrior here, then we can have this Rotto tank a hit. But okay, we have waited long enough. Let's see how the Beast of Nurgle hits something. Which one should I hit? I can probably hit that one anyway. So I'll hit him. He might... he'd probably stand firm, but we should see... Oh, it's just a push anyway. Alright, maybe next turn. So... this hit? Might as well hit him, right? Comrade the Blood Drinker, it's a push. Right, you're in the right video to see the push animation for every player here. Now, let's check out the Pestigore. We can give him another assist. Oh, here's their move movement. They run just like Chaos Warrior. Here we go. Attack animation for Pestigore is exactly the same as the Beast Boy. Unsurprising. Right, I can take a one die here. No, take a one die here. Sure, why not? It might be an armor break. Oh, we can see the animation. I'm not gonna follow. We see the non-follow. Ooh, it's a kick. That's different from zombies at least. So we're gonna have to wait for the AI for a while here. It's gonna try to make a cage with a limited number of players. We should have moved this guy over here and that guy here. Now this guy's gonna have to make a GFI. But he doesn't care. Let's push. Follow probably. This guy doesn't have any good hits. And he doesn't take any hits. Okay. Well, we can push a zombie into the crowd here. We might even be able to push a wolf into the crowd. With a little bit of effort. I'll try to do this again. Oh, we have people next to him. Alright, maybe next time. Only have plus one there now. And this is a negative. I actually need to move some players back now. Let's have a Rotter hit this guy. It's a turnover. That's a pretty dangerous one. He can actually be out of range. I'm gonna try to reroll that. Oops. Well, that didn't happen. Okay. Well, the AI gets the advantage. Should have just surfed this Sunday, I suppose. Well, that would have been a turnover as well. Can't do anything when you have no block. And roll two of those in a row. One animation. The stationary block from a Rotter. And I guess we saw the follow block from, or the no follow block from a Pestigore as well. They don't have, yes, they do have wards. Right, these guys get disturbing presence Disturbing presence and foul appearance. Oops, two die into two die. Well done. Didn't get the knockdown. That's a knockdown though. And we need to scramble back here and actually. Oh, the Rotters have five move. That's better than zombies. I'm tempted to push this guy into here to then be able to put him on the edge. But to do that, I need to gain some ground. Okay, here we go. Beast and Nurgle does something. Apparently, you don't get an animation when the opponent has stand firm. That might be it. Yeah, I think that's what happens for everybody. So 5 minus 2 is... That's just a 1 die. What I could do is knock this wolf down from here. That'll do. And stay. That'll give me a 2 die on this side. It has to kick it again. I had to do the same one here. I don't want to lose too much field position. I kind of want to get control of the game so I can choose what to do here. Well, that's the standstill animation. Not a drop kick, as you can see. Instead, it was like a two-hand slam, which is pretty nice. Now, we can't quite get to the ball carrier. I think I'm going to stand this guy up. And I think I'll blitz in here to gain some momentum. But first we should move... Let's see, this guy comes up here. And it's them running. This guy comes over here. Another running animation. This fellow... I'll mark this somewhere, I guess. We now have enough to knock him down. We already had enough. I didn't really need him there. Let's have a 2 die hit on him. Very good. Stand firm, we can't see an animation. That would be a good reason, I guess, to not play against Necro. And blitz the zombie. Again, I would like to not follow here, but... I'll follow just to see the different animation. Oh no, that's the same one. Maybe that's the one I did last time. I can't remember. Alright, let's see what AI... It would be nice if the AI could fail something quickly here. So we get to continue our bash down. That's why I shouldn't have followed that. That's more for seeing the animation. He actually chain pushes this guy up there. Doesn't really do him any good. He's gonna blitz back from 1 die. Push on a rotter. Didn't push him onto the ball carrier, that's smart. Red die, rerolled. And yeah, I wouldn't take that if you didn't expect a push or better. It's not a bad 2 die to take. Well, what we could do here is knock this guy over and then blitz the ball carrier. And I don't see any reason why we shouldn't. I'll once again try to see the Beast and Nurgle animation here. Nope. Well, we can see him pushing, maybe. I do want to follow that. Nope. And no animation there. Okay, so I need a knockdown here to be able to blitz forward. Okay, that's gonna work. Again, stand firm, can't see an animation. So here we go. I'll not follow this time so we can see the different one. And Yeah, I guess I push him straight into this pile of unhappiness here. Yeah, it's the hand slash and the horn. The horns when it's follow. Okay, that's over there. Another zombie. Getting good armor breaks here. Yeah, that's the armor break. And I don't think I can pick this up, but I can hit his wolf. Which is nice. Push is not what I wanted. I don't really want to take a one die here, because if it fails, it's pretty bad. That is, if I roll a skull, it's pretty bad. If I don't roll a skull, he has one dice. Actually, this guy has a two. And then he could have a two, and then the wolf could be three. It could be pretty bad. I'll take this one die. Yeah, good thing I didn't take the other one, because then I would probably have to re-roll it. Alright, getting too involved in the tactics of the game here. That's not the focus of this. The focus of this is to see the animation. Maybe I should try to foul someone. See a foul animation. Let's focus on the Rotters and the Beast of Nurgle, since the other seems to have the same animation, more or less. And Pestigore gets a wolf. What's the point of that? Another Pestigore going down. And he didn't do anything else. That surprised me. Okay, let's have to see if the follow-up animation is also the same. Different. That looks like a Chaos Warrior. Okay, so we can pick up the ball. We want to see the touchdown animations as well. Should we try to score on a Rotter first then? I'll try that pickup. Disturbing Crescent doesn't disturb pickups. And I don't think it disturbs our own moves. We need to hit with the Beast of Nurgle though, but I probably want to pick up first, because I don't want to push this guy onto it. Same here, really. Pickup's gonna be... actually, he has agility 3. I didn't notice that. That's not bad. Let's take the ball then. No. Okay, that's worth a reroll, I think. Oh, we failed again. Okay, maybe we don't get to see a touchdown here, but... it's unfortunate. Normally I would not have tried that first. Or reroll that, but I really wanted to get the ball on the Rotter. Well, our opponent has the same problems, apparently. So we're gonna have to have one of these silly things where no one can pick up the ball. Push him. No more rerolls. That's good. Let's try to free someone up here. He actually has a tongue sticking out of his helmet. Right down there. It looks like a tongue anyway. We can also zoom right in through him. I guess we should zoom in and have a look at some of these players. Does seem a little bit like the zombie animation, right? Not imagining things. Okay, let's try to knock some guys down. That's gonna free up someone. There's the standstill water animation. Let's get this guy upfield to score. Yeah, you run. And let's blitz here. Get Mika Rugtail off the ball. And onto the beast and Nurgle. Then I'd like to knock down this. Okay, that didn't work. Well, I'll follow and try again. That didn't work. I guess I'll follow, but that doesn't really do anything. Now I only have one dice over there. I have a two die on him. Decent. Put him back on the wall, which is not what I wanted. Could have put him there and then hit him with the beast. I guess we'll gamble on a beast hit here. He has someone next to him. Oh, unfortunately. So this is where our beast gets knocked out then. Oh, okay, he's fine. So that's what it looks like when he falls over then. Guess we have to see that too. Necro is a bit rough to play against with a fresh team. Oh, an injury. No long-term effect, but regeneration. So that's good. I don't know if they changed that thing where you can usually tell if he's gonna regenerate or not, based on if the animation shows or not. Now we have all animations on, so it's gonna show an animation anyway. Of course, now he's gonna take one dice, which is of course usually successful if you have luck. If he stays, he could have hit him, but he followed, so he won't. Alright, he has two players on the ball. We can knock one of them away, if we... Actually, we can't. Well, we can knock this away. Well, we have to stand the beast Nurgle up. Right, that worked. Let's move this player into scoring range. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so over here. Yes, we've seen the running animation now. You gonna take another hit. Bring this guy out. Good. I need to clear this guy off, so I'll do it this way then. And then the Pestigore could pick up the ball. He has 3 agility. That'll do. So this is our play then to score. We really don't have any reason to do any other hits. Let's try to do this. Alright, well, we still have a chance to do it on the next turn. But a very low chance. We have to make a 3+, 3+. Which is pretty difficult without a reroll. But we get the ball in the second round, so we can get a touchdown then. I would really have liked to score on the Beast of Nurgle. Let's see if we can at least see a hit from the Beast of Nurgle. Yes, hit on every turn, but we haven't gotten to see the animation yet. Oh, he marked our potential ball carrier. That's gonna have to be addressed. We can easily clear him out like so. I am gonna try for the hit with the beast of Nurgle. Oh, right, he had no one next to him, that was my bad. And, well, let's just try to play then. We roll a failure, and that's it. No score this half, but maybe we can see at least one of the touchdowns next half. Sorry about that, but even when you play the AI, it doesn't always turn out the way you want it to. No wake-up luck for our opponent, so we're gonna be two players up here, which is good. And let's see if we can have the Beast of Nurgle hit the zombie here. Can even get a 3 die if I manage to knock the other two down. So let's get the ball on a Rotter, because I believe the Pestigore's animations is going to be similar to Beastmen. Everything else at the bottom is similar to Beastmen, and I'm sure most of you have already seen the Beastmen animations. So let's put a few Rotters back here to get the ball. And I'd like to see a Nurgle Warrior score, but that's going to be more difficult. I guess the Beast of Nurgle is going to be the most difficult. Might not even be able to do that. Alright, here we go. There's that kill. Yep, it's the reroll, that's nice. Okay, that could be picked up. Still want to see this animation, but first let's try to knock these two down. I can get both, I can get a 3 die on that zombie. Good. Ooh, that's good. He's probably getting back because I didn't see any symbol for injury. And come on now. Oh well, roll another one. I don't want to waste a reroll on that. We're gonna get more chances to get injuries on Beast of Nurgle, hopefully. Okay, you were in a good spot to take the ball. Actually, let's show a foul animation here with a Rotter. I'm just gonna blitz this wolf first. I don't want to lose this game. That's would be a bit embarrassing. Okay, just because we have an animation to watch, I'll use that. The rerolls will only be used to ensure that we get to see animations. But that move was more for winning than for animations. Oh, that's a GFI, I didn't mean to do that. But fooled by the display. So let's do the foul first, actually. This is a pretty bad foul, not one you should make in a real game. But we want to see the foul animation. Okay, kinda looks like the zombie, but he did a little jump. Which I believe the zombie does not do. So this will be our chance. Hey, we got it! Ball carrying Rotter, that's good. Let's move this guy one back, just so he doesn't get any ideas sending wolves around. And I'll make a little bit of more protection on this side. I guess the Beast Nurgle is actually lost his tackle zones. So this is a little bit risky. I think he's gonna have to take a red die to open up anything here. Might even not be possible. So what's left to see? Well, all the touchdown animations. We haven't seen the Beast of Nurgle do any hits yet. I think that's it. I think we've seen both the hits from Nurgle Warriors and Pestigores. We haven't seen Nurgle Warrior or Pestigore foul. We haven't seen kicks from anybody but the Pestigore. I'm not gonna be easy to showcase any kicks here. And let's try to knock this guy down again. and give the Nurgle Beast another chance at this 3-die hit. Okay, here we go, finally. Let's do the follow-up hit first. So it basically just bumps it with its belly. Considering it has a very scary looking tongue, several sharp teeth and really strong claws, it's a bit surprising that its main method of attack is to belly punch like that. But fair enough. Gets the job done, apparently. 1, 2, 3. Well, it hasn't been getting the job done so far. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can get up to here. I guess I'll make a cage around this thing. Bunch of people. And then move downfield. Maybe we can score in 2 turns or so. So we need to see the Beast of Nurgle do a standstill hit. And a foul, right, we should foul something. I'll foul that then with a Nurgle warrior. Again, not a smart move. Actually, I fouled this one, we have a little bit of a better shot there. Just to see if they do anything other than the standard Chaos Warrior stomp. I'll mark this wolf. Maybe the AI will spend some resources. This Pestigore. Got a second Pestigore there. He's fouling. So I guess I'm assisting with him. Okay, let's see Nurgle Warrior foul. I bet I've been calling them Chaos Warriors a lot, but they're Nurgle Warriors. Not quite the same, I'd say. And he's badly hurt, but he's gonna regen. Did we get sent off for it? No, we did not. Okay. Well, animation for the win, I guess. So if this guy stands up, then we're gonna have a chance to do the no follow-up block. Even though I would like to follow up here. So definitely that hit. Ooh, well, he's cutting down. And stun. He does commit to this block, which is okay. The rotters are made to be hit. It'd be nice to see Nurgle's rot activate as well, but that'll be lucky break if we get that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It'd be nice to make one GFI here, but I'll do it next turn. Run with the ball. Can I get anyone else up there? No, I guess we're gonna have to wait to pass the ball foul to the end of the game. He only has 4 movements. That's less than the Chaos Warriors. Less movement, less agility, but more skills. Not the skills you'd normally pick, but some of them good anyway. Right, we do have a blitz here. I guess I could blitz here. With this guy over here. Okay, let's do this first. Okay, you should probably stand up also. This guy can move. Okay, I'll move him up, and now that'll block the blitz. That's too far. I can tag the zombie. Maybe he'll dedicate someone to that. Just baiting the AI here. Okay, let's try a standstill block here then. Ooh, I forgot about him being alone. Didn't work, but okay, I'll follow up and try it on the next time. I have to remember to treat him like a troll. That someone should be next to him before he makes his moves. Just something you have to learn. Same way I think I've learned it from trolls. We stun the wolf, that's good, and the other wolf is marked, so the score should be pretty unthreatened. I will score quickly here. If I get the opportunity. He blitzes him, okay, that's success, I guess. He did hold some attention. Well, that's not much of a movement at all. So now, I will hit this guy, I think. Try to knock him down on the spot. Oh, now he had someone next to him. I don't want to reroll the loner. He has loner. Stand you up. Why am I hitting here? There's no reason, really. Kinda wanted to knock someone down to make Pestig or Foul. Maybe I can do it here. Okay, that's gonna be rerolled because we can score this turn. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna have to see the Pestig or Foul later. I will try to score here. Even though I should, if I try to win this, I should definitely try to stall it. But I'm not trying to win, I'm trying to show off the rotter scoring animation. Stupid used up reroll, I guess. Oh, there it is. Well, that's... I can't remember the zombie animation for scoring. But I don't think it was that. Yeah, throws up in celebration. That's unique, I guess. And disgusting. But woke up the zombies, and now we're going to have to try to take the ball back from our opponent. Unlikely that we'll get a Beast of Nurgle score out of this. Especially if you want to take a standstill block as well, and a foul. But, you know, it might happen. I'll put him out here, and then try to kick to that side. Who knows? Scared him enough to make him change his setup, I think. Orbit Splinter, that's one of his. That's most of the zombie back there. And it's a touchback. Fair enough. Does he give it? Oh, that's good. That's close to the beast. If you were to hand the ball to the beast of Nurgle, that would be nice. How are you going to protect the ball there? Well, it looks like the beast is going to see some action here. It's going to mark it with a wolf. Again, if you are a necro player, you should not mark strength 5 mighty blow players with your wolf, unless it's a desperate last effort to protect the ball carrier or something like that. But you all know that. Water. Going down. And some more of that. There's one more animation to see, so I guess we'll keep this all animations on for a little bit longer. Fair enough. We can compare it to the zombie animations here, actually. And they are different. The rotters are different from zombies, even though they have similar looks. When did he move this guy? I don't know. Now, normally I would hit and follow up here, because that would give me a shot at the ball. But I do need to see the stand still animation from the Beast of Nurgle. Which one takes precedence here? Taking the ball or seeing the animation? Well, it's gonna have to be see the animation, right? The Beast of Nurgle's score is gonna have to wait, I'm afraid. Though we will try. Can he score if he doesn't move up this time? Maybe if I blitz with him, I can then move in afterwards. But then I can't blitz the ball anyway. But I can mark him at the Beast of Nurgle. That might be enough. So can you... Okay, you can do that. That's gonna get you surfed, but that's okay. It ties up his wolf, which is the only player who can really assist here. Maybe he can free some of these up. These two I don't care much about. I'll put one more in here so he can't free anyone up here. I guess... You come in here afterwards. And I guess you tie this zombie up? Well, here we go. Blitz then. Hang on. Change of plans. You come in here to assist, to activate him. To make the stupidity risk a little bit lower. Blitz him. I didn't get the knockdown. Oh well. I'll do that. Then I'll move in here. So that's the first time we've seen him moving, maybe. Alright, he might dodge away from that. Look with you. I'll do that, I suppose. I don't want to take that one die, red die. So let's just do that. See what the AI makes of this. I need my reroll if I'm to attempt to hand off to the beast. Well, it gets a knockout there. Blitz over on this side. Gets the knockdown. Strangely enough, because he never moves after that, and it's a turnover. Very well. Unfortunately, we are going to have to move the Beast of Nurgle now if we want to score with him, which I very much like. How about this? You knock the ball loose, please. Well, that's a bonus. Not where I would have wanted the ball to go. That's good. I'll put him here. And now I can blitz here. He'd be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He could still score. But he'd have to follow up here, and we want to see the standstill animation. That means we can't blitz this guy. We might still get a chance to see the standstill. Nautilus is gonna try to score, I guess. We can't get everything this game. So let's get the standstill animation. I'll blitz, hit him. Okay, reroll. Oh, really stupid twice. You really didn't want to cooperate this Beast of Nurgle. That's too bad. Right, stand firm. The computer always uses stand firm. The computer, I mean the AI. If it can. That That was new. Did you do that last time? Didn't you do a sort of a kick? Maybe they have different animations. Well, it's not going to be an animation here. That was the kick. Alright, well, we might be able to spawn a pestivore. We're after rerolls. So, the score is very, very unlikely. Should be, maybe should try to get a foul off. I do want that animation. Oh, he picked up the ball. Fortunately, he doesn't move after picking up the ball. That's something the AI doesn't know about. Fouling is also something that the AI never does. Turning over though, AI does now and then, but this time he decided to re-roll. And it doesn't look like we're going to be able to get a touchdown here, although maybe. Okay, let's see if we can get this knockdown for once. No, there's no such thing as a knockdown. The beast of Nurgle. Did get that werewolf though, that's good. Although the place where the ball landed was not the best. There's our pals. We need to get in scoring range, we have to ignore the ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. I'm gonna get up to here. That way he can score next turn if we can get the ball to him. Is there any chance of getting someone up there? Assist? Don't think so. So let's try this hit. Don't want to push him onto the ball, so I'll do that. Most likely he'll push me onto the ball. Oh, that's stupid. Should have saved him so I could foul with him, because we haven't seen his foul animation. He hits here with the same chance. Well, it looks like we might be able to see a foul animation, but I will probably go for the score animation at least. Anyway, okay, he did knock us down there, that means we probably have to go for just a foul. Yeah, this is going to be too tough to score. I'm just going to try to see the Beast of Nurgle's foul animation. That's at least something we can hopefully do. We need to knock down this wolf though. And then not roll very stupid. So I guess it's only about a 50% chance. Less than 50%. I guess technically we don't need to knock down that wolf. We can knock down something else in the range of him. The zombie. Let's try for the wolf first though. See what we can do. So this is a knockdown that we can foul with the beasts. Good. We can try to foul with the beasts. You can see this pattern here of disturbing presence zones. It's going to be real tough for passing plays against Nurgle. Alright, let's watch this then. Spins around and slaps him with his tail. And that's it. Got sent off for it. So no more watching our animations. I'm gonna turn them off here in the menu. Yeah, that's gonna be it for us then. Let's see, settings, cutscenes, on armor breaks is what I usually play on. I didn't get to see all the cutscenes animations. Hey, fall appearance right. That was first time of the game, right? And he rerolled it. And dropped the ball. Well, I won against the AI. Great for me. You're gonna have to try to score with a beast commander yourself, or you know, search for it on YouTube. There's probably already videos of it. I think the Nurgle looks pretty good. It's a little bit of a shame that some of the players are the same as Chaos players with different skin. But at least the Beast and the Rotters are unique. And you can't level anyone up. But that's not the point of this video anyway. So, I will probably be making a Nurgle team and trying to develop him a little bit in the open ladder, and I might also be back with some other new team for some more videos in the future. Our old teams are of course still there. You can play them in the open ladder if you want. So if there's one of the old teams you want to see back, then let me know. If there's some other things you want me to do in level 2, then let me know. Otherwise, look forward to shortly a first video of a Nurgle team in the open ladder. And something else, something different that I've planned that I might do, not 100% yet. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you again soon in the future.